Yoshi has defeated Aroniero Arurueri, the Noveno Espada. Rukia has fallen as well. At this crucial moment, the Septimo Espada, Zomari LaRue, appears to finish her off. But Rukia's brother, Captain Byako Yokuchki of the 6th Squad, arrives just in time and defeats Zomari. With her life saved by Byakuya, Rukia stands once more to aid Ichigo in battle.
Okay, here I go! Wait for us, Orihime! I'm coming for you too, Ichigo! Yakurai! Yakurai!
We'll save the salutations for later. Hurry up and go, Ichigo.
All right.
I'm leaving Orihime in your hands. Unfortunately, I don't have any time based on the likes of you. Defeated all of your underlings.
And what of it? You will know firsthand. You will now see the true power of the Calaveras with your own eyes.
So men of mine.
Do you think you can fend off the relentless attacks of the Calaveras?
Farewell. Don't take it personally.
Tsuginomai! Hakuden!
What's wrong? Unforgivable. Are you afraid of the divine power of Arbor? It will continue to give birth to my soldiers. An endless supply of my Calaveras. Unforgivable! Even with the power of a god, Lord Aizen did not allow me to become an Espada.
So men of mine!
And your little mob dares to challenge the Espada. This is the epitome of foolishness. Damn! Unforgivable!
If your power is merely giving birth to soldiers like fruit, then it's simple. I just have to freeze the branch that creates them. The frozen branches will never bear fruit.
So men of mine,
you shouldn't have revealed that power to me.
You will despair.
Farewell. Shomei no mai. Shuki shiro.
Lord Aizen.
I guess that's okay.
With the reinforcements from the Soul Society, the tide of battle begins to turn in their favor, or so they believe. But this was all simply a trap set by Aizen. Aizen has sealed the Garganta connecting Waco Mundo to the world of the living, severing the Soul Society's lifeline. He now begins his invasion of the world of the living. Moreover, though she had been freed, Orihime is captured once again. To save Orihime, Ichigo heads to the fifth tower, where Ulquiorra awaits him.
Let's go! Let's go! Take this!
I will protect my friend!
Wait for me, Orihime!
Yeah!
Are you afraid? Lord Aizen does not need you anymore. There is nothing protecting you now. If you die,
I'm not scared. Everyone is here to help me. That's why my heart is with them now. My duty is to protect Las Noches. I wasn't ordered to kill you. But you're different. Killing you is the same as protecting Las Noches. I will erase you with my sword.
Above the canopy of Las Noches.
Resurreccion, segunda etapa. Behold, Ichigo Kurosaki. This is the true face of despair. Let's go. Resurreccion segunda etapa. I'm the only one among the spies that failed to accomplish this second release. Even after seeing my new death, you still want to fight? Very well. Then I will gladly turn your bones to dust. I no matter how much you despair, in a run car, unfortunately, there's a world of difference between us. Imitating a hollow to gain power is understandable, but a hollow and a human are not equal. Unfortunately, let's go. The Black Zero.
This is the hollowfication.
Power!
foolish, Ichigo Kurosaki. You are challenging and trying to win against a man you fear deeply. That's nonsense.
I'm not fighting you just because I think I can win. I'm fighting you because I have to win.
Ridiculous.
I came up a little short. Let's keep this up! Here we go!
Ichigo challenges Ulquiorra in battle, but Ulquiorra, now in his true form, easily overwhelms Ichigo. Orihime reaches the battlefield just in time to see Ulquiorra's Cero Oscuras penetrate Ichigo's heart, effectively killing him. Orihime's cries of agony echo beyond the canopy of Waco Mundo. But that's when Ichigo stands up once more, this time with a monstrous visage. Just who are you? Vanish.
Let's go. Death. I'm asking who you are. Looks like you've forgotten how to speak. Unfortunate. Let's go. Ichigo.
No! It can't be! Really? Ichigo?
Unfortunate. I will teach you true despair. How's this? Give up now. I don't know how you became like that. But no matter how powerful. attacks become, they're still able to keep me. Unfortunate. Unfortunate. Let's go. Unfortunate. Let's go.
Delightful. I had to go to say something like that. Ichigo tried to save me.
Taking three Espadas with him, Aizen begins his invasion of the world of the living. However, the 13 court guard squads have already finished their preparations and are lying in wait. With all captains now at the ready, the Tenkai Ketchu placed in the four corners allow the real Karakura town to be replaced with a replica. The decisive battle between the 13 court guard squads and the Espadas is about to begin. Captain Toshiro Hitsugaya of the 10th Squad crosses swords with the Tercera Espada, Tia Hollybell.
Let's go. It's beginning. Be sure to keep your cool.
What are you talking about?
Let's go. Stay on your toes, Matsumoto.
Yes.
Senen Shoro.
Here you send me.
つらら
The shark will sink the dragon of ice into the sea.
Don't underestimate the power of soul reapers.
Let's go.
I will defeat your god. Now prepare yourself.
Say!
Hyoryu Senbi!
Senmen Hyoro.
Hyoryu Senbi!
I have an ice on
her. Hyoryu Senbi!
Water attacks will never reach you.
Use my power. Oh, it will.
Let's go.
I'll show it to you right now. Come on.
It's not over. I'm not going to fall for your cheap talk. Looks like you're waiting for the same thing I am.
Senmen
you're waiting for this entire area to fill up with water before making your kill. Let's end this. But let me ask you your name first, Espada.
Tercera Espada, Tia Halibel.
I am captain of the 10th squad, Toshido Hitsugaya. Let's go! Fine. Wait for the same thing, it will never...
Pure to me, pure castle.
As the 100 flowers bloom, your life will come to an end. I actually don't need to wait for water.
Hyoryu Senbi!
I hear Imaru is foremost among the ice elements. All forms of water are my weapons. The heavens are under my command. Sorry, but this isn't. I guess it's okay.